Ugh. All right. Going on? How's everybody doing? We're back for another exciting episode. What's up, Pickle? What's up, Null? Thank you for the birthday wishes. I would just like to say, it's not actually my birthday yet. It's tomorrow at midnight. At midnight tonight is technically, when it happens, when the threshold is crossed. We're just choosing to celebrate a little early. We're just choosing to celebrate starting the festivities slightly early. We're starting the extremely not special, uninteresting, nothing exciting happening festivities a little early, but yes. Is a good song, isn't it? I think I figured out what it is about that album that I find a little, I don't know, that didn't quite do it for me. I think I figured it out earlier today. Oh, I just blacked out for a second. Sorry. That was a Comatose by Glass Beach. Well, I think the name, he says Comatose in the song, but the title is spelled Commatose. Is that how you're supposed to spell comatose? I thought it was with one M. Is that supposed to be like a pun, like comatose? That's not actually how you spell that word, is it? I'm very confused. I always thought it was just coma, like you're in a coma, but I guess maybe not. I don't know. Anyway. I'm 1 year closer to becoming forgotten dust. I don't know if I'd say that. I'm probably going to be the most remembered dust of all time. My dust will never be forgotten. My dust will be venerated for generations to come. I will be highly honored dust. Thank you very much, if I must say so myself. There should be more grammatical errors in general media. That is correct. I agree with that. You'll remember me, but who else will? I mean, isn't that enough? If I could be remembered by one person, isn't that really enough? Yeah, just make them. Yeah. We need more of that. I need to fuck with people more. That's a good philosophy. Also, Pickle, I must say the image of an anatomically correct tiny CBD gummy bochi is now haunting my mind. I have not been able to chase that away. I have not been able to chase that particular phantom away. It stalks me like some sort of like the Hat Man, like I have taken too much Benadryl. And I am tripping on DPH, and now there's a miniature gummy bochi lurking in the corner of my room at all times. And I'm too afraid to look directly at her because I know that that will trigger her. She will activate, she'll take that as a threat, and I don't want that. Yes, it's truly, what a truly amazing combination of words you managed to come up with last night. That was truly something special. But yeah, last night was a good stream. Last night was a good one. Little quiet, a little slow, but sometimes you need those. Sometimes that's what you want. What up, Picture? I have some things that we need to talk about now that Picture's actually here. But I was talking about some stuff that concerned you last night, so we need to get the council's judgment. No, it's nothing bad. Oh, I mean, I guess it's kind of bad. It's nothing bad, but Picture did show me something earlier. Yeah, you're hit. Ooh. That's what I was about to bring up. Carlos showed me something earlier that made me very giddy, you know? I felt all tingly all over. I got a nice warm feeling running across my spine when I saw it. Yeah, it was good. It was very good. But I'm about to light my candle, and I have a pack of matches here. I bought some matches specifically. I heard that these were very high quality matches, and they're good for lighting a pipe. They're good for smoking pipe. Made by the Jönköping Vulcan Company of Jönköping, Sweden. 3-star safety matches of superior quality, superior Swedish quality matches. I have not used these before, so this is my review. This is my pro ASMR. Can you hear that? Can't really hear that. This is my full review. 3-star safety matches. We'll see. We're gonna light one up right now. Ooh, that was. All right, it went out, and I think I struck it a little bit too hard. The tip kind of exploded and then went out instantly. I think these are maybe a little stronger than I expected. So, first one, not so good, but I think I'm gonna chalk that one up to user error. I think that was my fault. I think I was a little too gung-ho there. But yeah, that was a nice, that lit very nicely. Hold on. Let's be a little more gentle this time. Oh yeah, you can light these with a feather touch. Holy shit. Nice even burn. Yeah, okay, these are good quality matches. I was not lied to. I nearly just fucking blew my fingers off with that. You can light these things with a fucking, they got a hair trigger on them. There's Bowser branded matches. I feel like I'm not in it for the clout though. I'm in it because I want good quality matches. Those are probably shit. Those are probably really bad matches. I don't want the name brand recognition. I want quality, you know? What up, Phineas? Is that a that is a lamp. Okay. And that's a Games Done Quick emote? Okay, sure. Is there a lamp there this year? Is there some famous lamp that they carted in? I thought it was a parfait at first. Like a sundae, you know? Like a fruit parfait. Don't know if that necessarily equates to quality, Noel. I think that was probably overkill in most situations. That was from the first GDQ. Okay. First GDQ during the pandemic. Okay. I don't know. I'm not caught up on my GDQ lore. I don't really watch speedruns. I'm sorry. I'm not a speedrun person. That's true. Maybe Bowser does make some good matches. I'm just saying, if I had to guess, I would guess they're not top quality, but yeah, when I'm using matches to light things, I'm generally like when I'm lighting a pipe, for example, I generally want to burn the tobacco inside at a nice even pace and not burn all of it to ash instantly, and the pipe, and possibly my own self. That's generally not what I'm trying to do. I mean, realistically, Bowser wouldn't use matches at all. He wouldn't need to. Realistically, Bowser is the last person you would expect to make quality matches, because he probably doesn't use them. He probably has no idea. Probably has no idea what makes a good match. Probably has no clue. Anyway, that's true. Bowser's a responsible parent. He doesn't want to be projecting that onto his children. He wants to make sure they grow up nice and healthy. But yeah, I went out tonight. I got myself a nice bowl of ramen. I got myself a little curry Nikuman as an appetizer, pretty good. Nice and crispy on the outside. I got some nice spicy tonkatsu ramen. And yes, ramen. I got the tonkatsu, and they let you choose 1 to 10 on the spiciness meter. And I said, give me a 7. I'm feeling a strong 7 tonight. And the waitress was like, are you sure? My server was like, are you absolutely certain that you want to get this? It's very spicy. It's way spicier than you probably think. And I was like, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. I appreciate the warning. It was extremely fucking spicy. It was really spicy. I cannot imagine doing anything more than that. I was like, that was like my limit. I can handle spicy food. I'm pretty good at handling spicy food. 7 out of 10 was like, I was like, I don't think I could do an 8. I'm like, I ate the whole thing and it was good, but I don't think that was like easily my limit. So I was like, do people get higher than that? Like, has anybody gotten a 10? And she was like, I've never seen anybody get a 9 or a 10, but somebody got an 8 at one point apparently, and they were not having it. They were screaming, they were crying, they were shitting, they were coming. It was horrible. It was a horrible sight apparently. Yeah, I mean the ramen there is pretty good. It seems pretty authentic. So, that 7 out of 10 is probably about. There's probably like some formalized scale, but yeah, it was pretty fucking hot. I definitely, like I said, I enjoyed it and it didn't put me out. But if I were to get it again, I would probably go like a 6. I don't think I would want to get that spicy again. Yeah, that's the same reaction that you have when you play Fear and Hunger too. Basically the same thing. I basically did the eating that bowl of ramen was basically like doing a full playthrough of Fear and Hunger. Now that you when you put it in those terms, yeah, that's basically what happened. One through 10, 20, and tie. That's amazing. That's what I'm curious, Pickle. I want to get a 6. I don't think I could do higher than a 7. And I want to get a 6 just to determine like what the gradation is on these levels, because it was pretty fucking spicy. Yeah, I can't imagine a 10 being enjoyable in any regard. The only person that I could imagine ordering a 10 like must just not be able to taste anything. Like maybe they just can't. The only reason they can eat the 10 is because their mouth just there's no sensory nerves left in their mouth. Because I can't imagine that it like is fun. But yeah, I did that, and then I checked out a little cafe around the corner afterwards. And I got myself a little cookie butter latte. Ooh boy. Oh man, decadent. Truly decadent. But yeah, I have a lot of spicy food, I got a lot of coffee, and I got a lot of milk in my stomach right now. So if partway through the stream I just fall on the ground doubled over with intestinal distress, you will know. You will. Don't worry. It's fine. That's like expected. Yeah, my mouth had a party tonight. Yeah, that's the only. Like, I can't imagine there's any joy to be had there. It's only if you enjoy pain. It's only if you like hurting yourself, which, coincidentally, I happen to enjoy quite a bit. Yeah, I think it probably would be. The scale probably is larger. I think it would have to be. Like, there's just no way. Like, I think once you hurt, what the? once you hit a certain level of spiciness, it's like it just becomes redundant. It just becomes point like once you reach a certain level of pain, it's like there's no, you can't inflict more pain than that. You can't make it hotter than that. You're just not feeling anything. Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. I've only had it once. This is the first time I got it, so I don't know. I can't gauge the different steps. I do like spicy food. I do enjoy. I want it. We should do a. We should do some spice related thing on the stream. That would be fun. I don't know what it would be, but that was one of the worst experiences I've ever had when I was working overnight. I had like ghost pepper wings at some restaurant, and they were pretty spicy. And then I had to go work an overnight shift. And about 2 a.m. in the middle of my shift, the food had worked its way to a certain point in my digestive system, and there was an emergency. I was like, I literally had to stop working and like sit on the ground. I was like, I feel like I'm about to die. For a solid like 15 minutes, I was just in the aisle, just like sprawled out on the floor, just holding on for dear life, just trying to stay in my body. It was not a good situation. Yeah, I like spicy food, but I don't need everything to be spicy. I like a variety of flavors. I don't need everything to be spicy. I don't need everything to be spicy. It was bad. That's probably, without exaggeration, I think that may have been one of the most painful experiences of my life. I've not been in any super distressing situations, to be fair. That was when it was bad. That was like some, I was concerned. I was like, something is not correct in there. Sounds like a very specific type of manga starting chapter. What type of manga would that be? What do you mean? How specific are we talking? But actually, before we actually start playing the game, we're starting a little bit later than usual, and I've already had my customary beverage. I had the coffee. I just finished it like right before the stream, so I didn't make any tea, which means I will be right back. I need to go get something. Too specific? Try me. Try me. But yeah, I will be right back. This will take 2 seconds. Enjoy the silence.
All right. Okay. It's fine. It's okay. Oh, wait. No, it's not. Never mind. Okay. We're gonna start the video game now. I promise. I promise we're gonna start the video game now. But yes, we're playing Metal Slug tonight. I'm giving myself a little treat. I'm giving myself a little birthday treat. And we're playing Metal Slug. We're gonna see how much Metal Slug we can play. Oh, I hit my funny bone. Ow. I have a special physical limited edition thing of Metal Slug Anthology for the PlayStation 4, so that's what we're going with. We are not playing this on real arcade hardware. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to disappoint. We are not playing this on an arcade cabinet. We are not playing this on a Neo Geo. We're playing this on the classic retro console, the PlayStation 4. I don't know. I actually haven't played this particular version of Metal Slug. I haven't played this anthology before. Okay, hold on. We're getting the crackling. We're getting the crackling audio. I forget how to fix this. I'm pretty sure you just plug it, you just unplug it and then plug it in again. And that usually fixes it. There we go. Am I gonna try Shooter's Blood and Teeth? I don't know what that is. There we go. It's Warhammer 40K Metal Slug style game? I mean, if it's Metal Slug, I'll try it. Like, I like those types. There's another one. There's like an indie one. There's like an indie Japanese one coming out called like Black Hand Jet or something. Jet Blackman. Black Jet Guy. I don't know. But they're like really going for the Warhammer, or not Warhammer, Metal Slug style. Let's see here. All right, it's frozen. The game capture is frozen. Can you hear it, by the way? No, you can't hear it. Hold on, what is this? This is the Elgato. Deactivate. Activate. Okay, it's just not working now. That's so sick. I love it when things just don't work. Let's try that again. Yeah, I'm not plugged into the Do I need to like Okay, hold on. Do I need to like turn off the whole thing? Do I need to just like, is this what we need to do? I know. Why does this shit never, it always works before the stream, and then when the stream starts, it just fucking, everything explodes. Everything collapses. Like so many, like a house of cards. Like so much sand. I'm not worried about it. I'm sure that it will be okay. I'm just tired of it. I'm just very tired of this. No, it's just not working now. Why did it do that? Okay, what the fuck is this? Deactivate. Activate. What do you mean there's no signal? I'm looking at it. Is that a song? I'm guessing that's a song. Is this it? Bro. What happened? Why did it? Whatever. Anyway, you can see it now, right? You can see it. You can see the thing. We're good. And you can hear it. You can hear it. We're good? Okay, perfect. All right. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get through at least. I wanna get through at least Metal Slug 3. I wanna play 1, I wanna play X, and I wanna play 3. I wanna play the good ones. I wanna play the good ones, and then we'll see if I feel like doing more tomorrow. But I also have myself a nice milk porter. I got myself some beer today. Ooh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Goes down smooth. Click the touchpad to use a select and start. Oh, why? Okay. Look at that. That's Soul right there. Look at that artwork. I've never played Mercenary. Was Mercenary King, did Mercenary Kings end up good? Why is that? Is this just a straight up port of the PS2? Okay. The PS2 anthology? That's a little weird. Okay. I really like the artist, the sprite artist who did the sprite art for that game, Paul Robertson, is extremely good, and I like his work a lot. He has a lot of independent short films, like Pirate Babies, Street Fight Cabana Battle 2006, Kings of Violence 4 billion percent or something like that. And then there's another one after that, I think. But if you've never seen Pirate Baby, if you've never seen Pirate Baby's Street Fight Cabana Battle, go check that out because it's fucking so good. And then the other one is not as good, but it's still very good. That guy's a big inspiration on me. My younger self found his work very inspiring, and I guess I still do find it very inspiring. Okay, see, this just says it literally. Okay. For play, yeah, I will create some data on my PlayStation 2. And why not? Oh yeah, baby. Oh, can I make this bigger? Is this gonna be like a tiny little thing on my screen? How does this work? Oh yeah. All right. Here's another question for everybody. Pop quiz in the chat. Which character do you think I play? Which character do you think I would always choose? Who's my Metal Slug main? That's her name, Nadia. I like Nadia a lot. She's not in every game. But I like Nadia. I just couldn't remember. I couldn't remember her name. No, she's in the later ones. I think she's in 4 and 5. Oh, yeah. I think she's in 4 and 5. I think she's in 4 and 5, and then do I have like options? Game options. Yeah, there we go. Oh, we could put scan lines on? What is this? Oh. Yeah, let's just do. We don't need that. We don't need the. Ooh, should I try to limit my. No, let's just do free play. I don't really feel like. I just want to play the games. Also, there's difficulties? Alright, whatever. No, I kind of just want to play the games. I mean, you can do a game over counter if you want. I think I'm pretty good at Metal Slug. I've played a lot of fucking Metal Slug, so I think I'll be okay. I think I'll be okay. It's been a long time, I'll say that much. It's been a long time, but I don't think I'll embarrass myself. Also, how's the sound now that we're actually in the game? Is it good? Should I raise it? Should I lower it? Good. Okay. Good on all fronts. Over. What was the thing you said the other day, picture? Clear on final or something like that? What's the radio thing? I can't remember the exact terminology. Clear on your final. That was it. Oh, look at that artwork. Nice. Yeah, the first one's not so great. The first one's easily the worst, in my opinion. They hadn't quite figured it out yet. I mean, compared to the later ones, obviously it's a fucking amazing game and it's so sick. Like, look at this. How do you top this? It's the greatest series in existence. What is happening? Why can't I start the game? Oh no, it started. There's just like. Okay. Wait. Do you not get to pick your character in this one? Hold on. Yeah, we're playing Metal Slug. What up, Seamus? Slug, slug. There kind of was. No, I guess you're right. I guess it is just Marco and Tarma. All right, so you'll have to wait for the answer to which character I pick until the second game, till we get to X. All right. Sorry, I was confused for a second. I was waiting for the character select screen to come up. But yeah, I haven't played the first one too much. X is definitely one that X is my favorite, but I have a story about Metal Slug X when we get to it. I'm probably just gonna play X. I'm probably not gonna play 2 regular. Oh, I didn't want to pick that up. There's like a little bit of lag. Okay, I looked at the chat. I feel like I need to restart the game now. I feel like I already need to restart the game. Yeah, I did not realize how popular Fio was. That was like a later in life realization for me that Theo's like super popular. I can't look at this chat at all or I'll just die. That was the second time I looked down at the chat and I died instantly. Oh no. Yeah, I don't know how this is gonna go. I'm not used to playing like twitchy like arcade action games on stream. This is gonna be bad. No, I already did. You can't pick your character in this one. I already tried that. I know. I didn't realize it, I guess, when I was a wee lad. Before I was exposed to the internet, really, I didn't understand that Theo was like the go-to. Ah. I mean, I'm not saying I don't understand the appeal. I'm not saying I don't understand the appeal, but oh man, look at those cool Nazi flags in the background. Look at those cool, I forget what the name of the enemy organization is in this game. I'm not big on the Metal Slug lore, by the way. I don't know the Metal Slug lore. Can you crawl? Oh, you can. I was gonna say, were you taking that time to look up Art of Theo picture? Oh yeah, the sprite work in Metal Slug is unmatched. And this isn't even like the best. This is the first one. It gets better. Right, good night, Pickle. How do you get down there? Oh no! They killed that frog, dude. That's fucked up. Kitchen and bar. I really like all the mechanical designs in these games and like how goofy they look. They're so good, man. Thanks, Pickle. I appreciate that. It's not often I get called a real one, but I appreciate it. Is that true? Does it all take place in the same universe? I didn't even know that. I'm not good enough to be going for these extra points. This extra ammo. God damn it. There's like a tiny bit of input lag, which is unfortunate. I have a feeling this is not the best way to be. Shotgun! I gotta get the shotgun! How do I get off this?
No! No!
Ugh. That doesn't count. That death right there doesn't count. That was me trying to show off. Yeah, the sprite artwork in these games is unmatched. When you're somebody who wants to like get into making sprite artwork, you may think that you want to look at Metal Slug for inspiration. Don't do that. You'll only end up disappointing yourself if you do that. Ah, god damn it. I didn't think I was gonna jump right into it. Yeah, I was about to say, oh my god. Yeah, see, there's a little bit of input lag. I don't like that. We'll see how much, we'll see how I'm able to get through Metal Slug X. That's the one that I've played through the most, so we'll see. Okay! Like, just look at these backgrounds. They didn't have to do that. They didn't have to go that hard. Oh, I did the self-destruct by accident. Alright, that's fine. I didn't need the tank. I did that on purpose. That was a stylish maneuver. I did that on purpose. Oh my goodness. There we go. I was gonna say, this thing has a lot of fucking health. Samurai Shodown also exists in the same canon? Holy shit. So there's like an entire history of the world being played out. There's an entire history of the SNK-verse. There we go. They do exist in the same universe, Seamus. I know that that's probably too much for you to handle. That's probably too much, that information is probably overloading your brain, but... Oh man, I just realized when the helicopters drop when they drop those little letters, that's like the letter that the soldier was gonna send to his loved ones back home. That's kind of fucked up. What the fuck is this thing supposed to be? Like, what's going on here? What was the plan? No, turn around. What was the plan with this particular, encampment? Yeah, as long as we live in a timeline, as long as we live in a world where anime girls are real, it's fine. How are you supposed to tackle this? Did you just say, okay, that was a little cheap, I think. I think I chose perhaps the wrong moment to tackle that. Okay. Come on. This guy... His movements, he's too powerful. Yeah, he's like... He's Vulcan Raven, but even cooler. Alright, I think we got him. I think we got him in a loop. There we go. Alright. Oh, and there's a little grave. Damn, this game is sad. This game really makes you think about the harsh realities of war. Hello? Okay. We're frying up some chicken. That's also another thing that is really cool about this game, is the little pickups. The little score pickups that you can get will change over time. Like, if like those little like food cans and things like that, they'll go rotten. Or like an egg will hatch into a chick or something that you get bonus points for if you wait. There's like a bunch of cool little details like that on the score pickups. Come on. Come on. Wait a minute, I just realized the numbers on the sides of the tanks are 88. Those tanks. Did they do that on purpose? Did they do that on purpose? Okay, this particular barrel of TNT is taking a long time to explode. There we go. Nice. Is that cannon? I don't know if I believe that. Oh man, look at that background. Look at the sky. Look at the sky. That's so cool. There we go. I know, just the amount of sheer craft that goes in, that went into these games is just insane. They were really just on a completely other level. I don't think I want to be up here. Can I go down there? Can I get down there, please? No? Okay. I don't think I want to do this right now. I know, this was a bad idea. Okay. I think this game definitely feels a little bit less, I don't know, fair than the later ones. I feel like some of these situations are a little bit rougher than maybe they should be. Okay, okay. Oh, you can blow those up. Alright. Oh! Come on, shoot, shoot, shoot! Alright, this thing is kinda... a little... not the best boss. A little too tanky. There we go. Nice. General Fulbright, Private First Class Orange, and Private First Class Kiwi-kun. Ooh, I like this song. Okay, that was pretty sick. That was pretty cool. How do I get up there? Oh. I looked at the chat to see Null saying me dying, to see Null putting in me dying again. Okay. I don't know how you're supposed to get up there. And that killed me. So that's pretty sick. That was pretty cool. I liked that a lot. Oh yeah, this part. I remember this. I always thought this was really cool. Like, they really didn't have to do that. They really did not have to do that, but they did. Can I? Okay. I know, I'm telling you, they were on another level when they were making this game. This whole series, they just... They knew what they wanted and they went... Can I just keep going? Do I have to stop at all? Okay. Damn, this game is hard. I don't remember the other ones being nearly this hard. I already said that, but... I'm trying to do viewer engagement, okay? I'm trying to engage the viewers. I know that there's a lot of, it's a common question. You know, what's the best video game shotgun? Fuck. You know, you can see up that girl's, up that doll's skirt. That's not good. I think for me, it's easily the Metal Slug shotgun. I don't think there will ever be a better shotgun than the Metal Slug one. The super shotgun in Metal Slug is just... How do you beat it? How did you get better than that? Oh, that will just kill me. Okay. I should have known that that would happen, but... Oh, that was the boss? Okay. No, I think Metal Slug still wins. I think Metal Slug still wins, in my opinion. You know, I've not played Borderlands, so I can't comment on that. I'm not a Borderlands head, so I don't know. I love this. I love all the cityscapes in these games are so good. I have to jump to get that? Just let me. Oh my god. Alright. Holy shit, dude! What is this? Oh, look at that. You got the little piggy, you got the dead butcher. Ah! No! Oh, I fucking hate that. I always do that by accident. Can you kill these? Is this thing taking damage? Okay, yeah. It didn't look like it. Oh, the cars just crumple into dust. The entire car is a crumple zone. Alright. That sign just says Playa. Okay. This is... Okay, we hit the difficulty spike. They knew that you were too far in the hole at this point to just stop playing, so they said, fuck it. You're either gonna give up... You either already gave up, or you're way too far in to give up now. Holy shit! This is ridiculous. Oh, there's a little sexy poster. Nice. Oh no, I destroyed it. Okay. No tanks. Get him out of here. Please. Get me out of here. Jesus Christ. Okay. Yeah, we're just in full... We're just in full quarter muncher mode now. All semblance of skill has left my body. What is this thing? Whoa, look at those, like, weird... Look at those weird towers in the background. What is that? Those things are cool. Can we go to one of those? Oh, isn't this like... Is this the first boss in Metal Slug X? Or something like this? Alright, this is a pretty good boss. This one's not so bad. I also have a shitload of grenades. I always forget to use my grenades. For Sergeant Antigone. I don't know, did I? I don't even remember. There's so much shit happening. Hey, it's our buddies. I don't know what that guy was planning on doing, but I saw him. Okay. Look at this shit, man. This is stupid. Alright, we're going down. We're going down below. Holy crap. Yeah, it's kind of... In this game... In particular, I feel like it's kind of difficult to tell what you're looking at sometimes. The screen can get a little bit busy. maybe a little bit more than it should. Okay. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Okay. Alright, now the chat is just gonna be back. The chat is just gonna be. Oh no! It's just gonna be an ascending count of numbers. This is stupid. This part of the game is stupid. Maybe I hate Metal Slug. Maybe I actually hate Metal Slug. I take back everything I said earlier. Maybe these games actually suck. Okay. Nice. Just take a casual sip from the canteen. Wait, I have to advance? What? Where? Oh, I'm on the fucking... Oh, the controls are not great. I can't really... I can't really maneuver properly. It's a little awkward. Okay. Oh! No, I don't want to... No! Oh, this sucks. Oh, am I supposed to, like, be defending this thing from the bombs? Is that what's happening? I can't even tell what's going on. No, okay. No, get off of the thing! Get off of the turret! Stop! Make it stop! Can the game be over now? Oh no, oh no! They're firing little Chinese fireworks at me. Oh god. Oh, look at that. Okay, let's take it back. Let's take it back to the streets. I don't know what's happening. No! Okay, I got it. I'm in a rhythm now. I feel the rhythm. I feel the rhythm of the night. No! I see you guys. What does that say? Untsuru something me. I can't tell what that character's supposed to be. It's not Tahiti. It does not say Tahiti Maru. It does, in fact, not say Tahiti Maru. No, I fucking hate the helicopters are, like, impossible now. I don't understand. There's, like, no... You do not have enough time to weave in between the bombs. Okay. Are we at the end now? Is this the end? Oh, look at that. That guy made it pretty far. No! Oh, that's cool. That's a cool effect. How they come at the camera. They're like a made up military. I think they're literally called the normal army or something like that. The regular army. I think it's regular army. I think they're literally called the regular army. Yeah, the leader's Morden. It's General Morden. That's that guy. Like I said, I'm not an expert on the Metal Slug lore, but I knew some of it. Okay. Is this the last boss? There's no way this is the last boss, right? He's gotta, like... Something's gotta happen, right? Okay. Oh! I also like how you can see the, you can see the plane when it starts to... When it does the drive-by, watch. You can see it just respawns in the top right of the screen. It just completely resets. It doesn't actually fly over there. Rebel army? Okay. There we go. Oh, that was violent. That didn't make me feel good. Nice. Mission all over. That's what happens when war is done. That's what happens when war is finished. How do I... Yeah, no, that's what I... That's the correct... Okay. That's what happens when war is finished. All the soldiers assemble outside the, they assemble back at base, and then the general comes out, and he does a big salute, and he says, "Mission all over!" And then everybody claps, and they go, they throw their hats up in the air, and they go back to the barracks. Super Vehicle 001 Metal Slug. Yeah, they all get a printout of their KDA. Alright, thank you for your service, Noel. Go towel off. Go get a snack. Go get some water. You're gonna need it. There's also a great credit sequence. Max D. Also, like, Metal Slug is, like, a weirdly cinematic series. Like, look, like, this is, like, artistic. This is an artistic credit sequence for an arcade game about shooting... About getting a heavy machine gun and mowing down tons of soldiers and blowing shit up. This is, there's, like, some direction going on here, you know? Yeah, this isn't made by a bunch of these fuckers never made a made a single devlog in their life. These motherfuckers would not be caught dead making a devlog. See, look, she lost her fucking boyfriend in the war, in the carnage. That's a unique skybox, too! They made a whole new skybox just for the end credit sequence. Good job, Nazca Corporation. A devlog is like a blog, but for a developer. So, like, they talk about the development of their game and stuff like that. And most of them are shitty. And picture peace forever until the 16 other games in the series. Look at that high score, baby. Number one. But yeah, picture has a bad habit of finding devlogs that he knows that I'm gonna hate, and sending them to me. It is an addiction. You are addicted. And look, I talked about this last night, picture, and I need to bring it up again because it needs to be addressed. I think you and I work very well together. I think you and I work very well together, and I think we make a solid pair. The only issue, we've got too much hater energy. Between the two of us, we've got two. We feed off of our each other's hatred in a bad. We create a feedback loop of a hater power, and it's not good. We need to be careful about that. No, there's definitely already dev TikToks, but we're gonna do the first anti-devlog. Most devlogs are very positive, and they talk about how, like, you can do it, you should make video games, making games is fun. Anybody can make a game. And we're gonna do the opposite, and we're just gonna be super ultra negative, and we're gonna shit on everybody. We need to get into like a CEO mindset picture. We need to build up our shell corporation of a Spite Corp into like an evil. We need to become evil businessmen. We need to get on that CEO grind set, and we need to become evil businessmen. That's the plan. I went into a whole rant on this last night. I went into a huge, gigantic rant on this last night. There's no way. That has to be taken. Evil Corp has to be taken. There's no way. I mean, if it is, if it's not taken, you gotta... I mean, I think I like Spite Corp better. I think I like Spiteworks better. As the name of our evil conglomerate that we own, but Evil Corp is good too. But yeah, that's what I was talking about that last night, about how I'm like, we need to be careful. We need to be super careful, man, and like not... We can't go too hard. We can't go too hard. I'm nervous. But yeah, I'm gonna take a quick break. And I'll be right back. And don't go anywhere. Because I have an extremely heartwarming, very sappy story to tell. When I get back, I have a very personal connection to Metal Slug X. So get excited. Get excited for some new lore. We're going to be adding some new lore to the channel when I return, so be excite, okay? Be very excite. Yeah, I'm gonna take a quick break, and I will be back momentarily. Ah, shit. I'm getting messages. Sorry. I need to like not look at messages. I need to remember to not look at messages between the between breaks, because they'll distract me. I need to not look at messages. I got a little cutie pie sending me messages, and it's distracting me from my hardcore gamer mentality. But yeah, I will be right back. Oh. Man. Being happy sucks. I hate this. I just want to be evil. Why can't I just be miserable and depressed all the time like I used to be? Why do I have to like feel good feelings? I hate it. It sucks. I know, it's awful. I just want to be evil. But I can't do that anymore. It's horrible. Truly, we live in a society. At least we do now. What kind of cookies you got, Noel? Even if they are awful, what kind are they? Were they made to be awful? Like, Are they like sawdust cookies? Or are they just like chocolate chip, but they're not very good? Keebler faux fudge? That's weird. What do you mean by faux fudge? I was gonna say something about being evil. Oh yeah. I had a breakthrough last night. I had like a huge breakthrough in terms of like my art and my philosophy. I realized something very important. We'll see how that bears out. We'll see if that ends up bearing fruit. Also, I didn't say anything, Seamus, but I'm glad you agree with me. I'm glad you agree with me about being happy, feeling it doesn't feel right. I don't like it. I was like thinking about what I want to work on in terms of my artwork and like that kind of thing. And I realized that my visual art is like my least, I'm the least interested in it, I guess. Yeah, I'm not very good at texturing. But I realized I kind of don't care. I realized I kind of don't, I'm kind of not interested in making a pretty picture anymore. I kind of have way, I have other stuff that I want to do, and my art is sort of a delivery vehicle for other things. And I obviously want to work on it and get better, but I can't think about it in those terms. That's not how I need to be like viewing my progress. No, it's becoming even stronger. It's becoming even, the career is becoming even more, I don't know, it's hard to articulate, but like, just improving at like visual representation is not my main thing. That's not my my number one goal. I need to stop worrying about that so much, I guess. But anyway, it's time to play Metal Slug X. It's time to play my favorite Metal Slug. Like I said, it's difficult to articulate, but it makes sense in my brain. In my brain, in my dumb brain that doesn't think properly, it makes sense. I told you, this is the one that I played. Ooh, look at that concept art. This is the one I've played the most, so I feel like I'll be okay. But there is a little bit of input lag here, so. Oh, yeah. Nice. But I have a story to tell. I have a story to tell about Metal Slug X. So, back when I was a wee lad, back when I was a back when I was a child, a naive child, there's a bowling alley by my house, and at that bowling alley, they had an arcade, they had a single arcade cabinet. And that arcade cabinet was Metal Slug X. And I played it one day, and I tell you, it was a religious experience. It was a revelation, you know? It was like I saw the face of God, and I understood then what it meant to have a video game. I understood what video games could be. And I would save up all of my quarters. I would save up all my quarters and get huge, gigantic bags of quarters. And I would tell my mom, I want to go to the bowling alley today. And we would go to the bowling alley and not even bowl. I would just sit at the Metal Slug X machine and play it for as long as I could go, with as many quarters as I had collected. And I was so enamored with that game. And then one day, at some like used game store or something, I saw they had a copy of Metal Slug X for the PlayStation 1, and it blew my mind. It blew my fucking brain wide open. All over the counter, all over the display. Every other game was splattered with my gray matter, because I was destroyed. It had not even occurred to me that you could have a home version of an arcade game. I didn't even think of that as a possibility, that I could own my own copy of Metal Slug X. So obviously I bought it. The only problem was I didn't have a PlayStation 1. So I had a copy of my favorite game in the entire world for a console that I did not own. And I was like racking my brain. I was like pleading with my parents for days. I was going fucking psychotic, being like, how can I finagle a PlayStation 1 out of my parents? I'm just a little kid. I'm just a little child. I have no money. I have no way of earning money. There's no way I could save up any amount of allowance to buy a console. How do I finagle a PS1 out of these people? And it was a difficult task. It was not easy. And I was, for days, I was like racking my brain. I was having convulsions. And then one night, a couple days later, after I bought the game, one night, one of my friend's parents comes over and she's like, "Hey, my son is a little shit and he does not listen to me and he does not pay attention and I need to punish him. So I took away his PlayStation 1. Do you want it?" And so through my friend's disobedience and just being a little shit, I somehow got a free PlayStation 1 out of the deal for literally no reason. It was a horrible day for him, but a huge come up for me. And and then I played the shit out of Metal Slug X. I played so much Metal Slug X. They had a mode in there where you could do challenge missions, and they had a cute drill instructor, and I got a crush on the drill instructor. It was a magical time in my life. I looked at all the concept art, and I was inspired. It was like, it was beautiful. Fate did align for me. In that moment, I knew that there was a higher power. In that moment, I knew that God was real. He was looking out for me. She returns that crush, you'd be perfect. I know, no. Don't you worry, I know. But you had a copy of Metal Gear Solid 3 that you couldn't play? Anyway. That's my story. That is the most, like, I don't know. That was a very important time in my life. A lot of things really came together for me during that period. First M-rated game and the first console? I think the first M-rated game I had was Resident Evil 4. Oh yeah. Look at these fucking chumps. Look at this horrible, disgusting character art that they made. It's so good. Why does it, like, load? Oh, this is not a good port. I think this might be a terrible port. Yeah, Theo's fucking, she's got a lazy eye, she's high as fuck. But yeah. You were the only one that guessed null, but you were also correct. I am an airy man. Wow, already this game just looks so much better. I know, you do know me much better nowadays. You know me way too well. It's not good. You've seen too far. You've gained too much insight. You've got eyes on the inside now, and that's not good. God, just look at all the detail. Look at all the detail in these backgrounds. Marriage is... Don't joke about that. You're not allowed to joke about that. Alright, it doesn't come up often, but you're not allowed to, you're not allowed to make jokes about marrying me, okay? Unless you, unless you're willing to put a ring on it, don't make claims that you can't back up, okay? I don't know if I know what Blade of Darkness is. But yeah, I think Resident Evil 4 was like the only M-rated game that I really wanted to play. So that's like why it was like, I never really cared about other M-rated games. I always thought that was cool that you could see the aliens in there in the first level. It's like a nice little detail. We saved this child. How do I get off this thing? First person, yeah, I don't know. Oh, okay. Never mind, I didn't pick it up. I do hate having my hopes crushed. That's not a funny thing to joke about. Look, my marriage prospects are not they're not looking too hot right now. So unless you're willing to back up those claims. Let's not make jokes like that, okay? Also, I was right, this is the first boss. I didn't realize that this thing was in a Metal Slug 1. Yeah, see, like, this is a reasonable pattern. This, like, makes sense. This is a reasonable boss pattern. See, look at that. I'm so much better at this game. I know how to play this one. You're great. I am great. Thank you, game. I appreciate that. Don't say that. Don't say that. This is what I'm talking about. There's too many people who are too nice to me these days. I don't like it. I can't deal with this shit. Look at that reuse. Look at these fucking backgrounds. Look at how much shit isn't reused. Also, the laser effect is just so good. This game is so good. This is the best game ever. Nope. Come on. Also, I think it was just that this game seems very responsive. I think maybe that's just like something that was in the first game. I think the first game just has built-in input lag, because this feels fine. Also, these fucking stupid mummy houses. The mummy booths that show up. Oh no, I didn't get the super flame shot, fuck. I didn't realize that was like so strictly timed. I miss power-ups, man. Not enough games these days have power-ups. We need to bring back power-ups. Oh, yes! Like, look at this shit. This is so good. Oh, are there aliens in the... Are there ancient aliens in the background? There should be. Oh, that would be a nice detail. I don't know if they did that, though. I never played the Metal Slug mobile game. I know that there's a bunch of stupid-looking characters in it. There's a bunch of stupid-looking waifu bait characters in it. How do you do this guy? Okay, there we go. Yeah, then he blows himself up. Okay. There's a bunch of really stupid-looking characters. Kakar Leona's cannon? Oh no. Like, look, all the mummies have, like, unique death animations, or, like, unique death sprites for being on fire. They're all so detailed, they didn't need to do that. Look at this guy! I missed the monkey. I was not able to save the monkey, I'm sorry. Also, I'm not going to be showing off the transformations. I'm going to try to play the game seriously. I know that you can get turned into a mummy, but I'm not going to do it. If I don't have to. Ah. Okay, as I say that. So yeah, now all this shit will kill me. Oh, this is a bad situation, man. Okay, never mind, we got it. I forgot I had fire bombs. Yeah, you get this stupid floaty jump now. Okay. We need to go find some rave juice so that we can de-mummify ourselves. No, I would like to become normal again. The crouch animation is real good, though. Okay. There we go. That was almost bad. Shotgun. No, shoot him! Okay. Nope. Okay. No, it just says human when you turn, like, your power-up is that you became human again. Like, instead of flame shot coming up, it says human, because you became human. You got humanity. There we go. Human! It should say that. It's kind of disappointing that it doesn't. Nice. We got another super vehicle. Super, yeah, you should become like a super soldier if you pick that shit up. This is such a cool fucking boss, man. They really upped their game on the in the boss department in the sequels. Oh, I did it again. I hate that jump and shoot is the combination they went with for suicide. That's so stupid that that's your suicide attack button. But what can you do? God forbid you start mashing buttons in this arcade Twitch shooter. I have 35 grenades. I just realized. Oh, he only did the laser beam once. Sergeant Sisyphus. See? Look! That's two missions down without a death. I told you, I'm good, I know how to play this game. The first one is just bullshit. Okay, come on. I can't even argue that though. I did know life this game. I did know life this game for an extremely long period amount of time. And like, look, you have little reload animations. Oh, I'm big. You're big. You can't wear that. You're big. I would love to do a world peace watch through at one point, but I would definitely get in trouble. I'm definitely not allowed to do that. Oh, that kills you? Okay. Well, that was unfortunate. That was a lame way to die. Yeah, if you're fat for too long, your character just dies of a heart attack after like a certain amount of time. It's a very controversial mechanic they included, but it was a different time back then. You were allowed to do things like that in video games. And nobody cared. Wait, am I eating the pigs? Am I eating the live pigs? That's weird. I don't know if I ever noticed that before in this stage. Or if I remembered it. That's horrifying. Why would they do that? Why would they do such a thing? Nice. Oh yeah, and I realize part of my game design philosophy, I want to take a lot of inspiration from arcade games. Damn it. I want to make a game that's like on this level at some point. Maybe not necessarily like in terms of everything, but I want to make a really good arcade game. At least once in my life. I think that's a laudable goal. I like this thing too. I always thought this boss was really cool. I don't know why, but I like this design quite a bit. And I like that it has the tanks. It just spawns tanks out of it. I'd say that's pretty good. I'm satisfied with that. Oh no, I forgot! I hate the drop shot! I fucking hate this gun. The drop shot fucking sucks. Fuck this thing! I forgot you can get the drop shot there. That's the one mar on this game's existence. I want the fucking jet. Whoa! I would say that's pretty good. I'd say first continue, like, partway through the third stage is pretty solid. I'm satisfied with my performance. I'm sure it's only going to go downhill from here, but... Yeah, I don't know what they were thinking with that one. It's just a worse version of the Iron Lizard. They already have a gun that does that, and it does it way better. I don't understand what they were thinking with the fucking drop shot. Oh yeah, that fucking Neo Geo base. Yeah, and with a way better name and design. God, all the mech designs in this game are so good. I don't understand how they were able to do it. How are they able to make a game this good? I don't get it. How were they able to do it? It shouldn't have been possible. And look at that, the fucking it's radiating heat out of its legs. Iron Lizard, they look stupid too. If you actually get it, if you look at the actual sprite of the Iron Lizard, they're very goofy looking. They're not a weapon of war. Hello? Why is it, stuck in a loop? Why is it doing this? Okay, there we go. Nice. Also, I just realized you cannot get bonus lives in this game. I beat two full stages without dying. I got mad points from that. And I did not get an extra life. You do not get extends in this game. Oh yeah, we're in Chinatown. I forgot that this level was in this game for some reason. I associate this cityscape with Metal Slug 3 for some reason. Oh yeah, I remember the stage now. Oh no, I forgot a Metal Slug X stage. That's not good. My brain really... Nope! My brain really is fucking addled. How did that happen? Ugh. No, get me up there, get me up there! Ah! Okay, I deserve that. I deserve that for being greedy. Oh yeah. Ugh. I registered half a second too late what that was. Oh, look at that! Hold on, can we get that again? That was, I don't know if I... Look at that! They didn't need to do that! And then you get a different idle animation after it's over? They really didn't need to do that! Look, it doesn't even... This gun fucking sucks. I hate this shit, man. Get me out of here. Damn, I kind of want to practice 1CCing this game, though, if I can do that. I definitely can't do it. It's definitely incredibly hard, but... I'm feeling my fucking... The desire returning. How much I love this game. Stone! Oh yeah, I forgot you can get... Okay. I got the big laser and I got rocks. And I fucked it up immediately. Yeah, that's what I don't understand. It doesn't... It fires so slowly. And it doesn't do anything special. It's just not a good gun. I need to stop looking at the chat. I'm like engaging the viewers way too much. Can I pause this? How do I pause the game? There we go. UNCC Jet Gundog's Jet. I forgot that I don't have MAME set up. I don't know what happened, but I had to delete MAME at some point, so I don't have MAME set up. I was gonna try to play that game the other day, but... And I was like, I gotta fucking set up an emulator right now. I do not feel like doing that. I think these aliens might be my favorite... Some of my favorite character designs of all time is the aliens from Metal Slug. They're so silly looking. They're so silly looking, and the animations that they have when they die are incredibly violent. We're not gonna see that until later, but... They bleed real good. These guys. I like the way they bleed. I'm like having way too much fun now to like be paying attention to the video game. I'm sorry. I blew up the fucking tank too. Is there a Dirt Jeep compilation pack? Oh, and this is, you get armor piercers! We're not gonna get to see the armor piercers! Fuck. I need to restart the game. Can you get armor piercers anywhere else in the game? There's like probably one other spot, right? But I don't even remember. That's like a gun. That's a not a gun. A tank specific power up is the armor piercers. They kind of went nutty with this game, huh? I'm realizing they really did it up in very good fashion. Yeah, I mean, I guess I could check out the Dirt Cheap compilation pack. I did not know that existed, but do you know it's cheaper than Dirt Cheap? Free. Did you? I don't fucking remember. You think I remember these things? I barely remember what happened at the beginning of the stream. That's not a slight against you. That's not a slight against anybody. That's just... that's all on me. Hog. The hog truck. Dude, calm down! Holy shit, they're chucking! No! I need to... can you, like, unbind that? Where's the options for this arcade game? Can you unbind suicide on your fucking vehicles? I mean, I know that I rambled to the beginning of the stream, but I meant, like, specifically. That happens at the beginning of every stream. Oh yeah, the spicy ramen. That's probably why I don't remember what's happening. I'm too spiced up. All of my brain juice is going to, it's all in my stomach right now, trying to deal with that. Trying to deal with the impending crisis that I'm gonna have to face later as a result of my life choices. There we go. What was the final count on the first Metal Slug? Like 17? We're easily on pace to beat that. Okay. We're easily on pace to beat 17. Also, I don't know why I'm throwing grenades at this thing. This is the drop shot. That's the drop shot of the enemy forces. Is those fucking... whatever those... whatever that armor is. She's also very cute. The, whatever her name is. I have some very cute art of her saved on my computer. Oh! He faked me out. He anticipated my movements. Does she? I know, the fucking helicopter was reading my inputs, that was crazy. Ugh. Alright, yeah, the game is hard now. I need to stop... engaging the chat. I'm not even doing a very good job of it, either. You either get subpar gameplay, or you- oh, I love this part. This part's sick. What up, Nice Ice? Okay, we got it. We're playing, Metal Slug, the greatest video game series to ever exist. I think I've seen that one. I think I've seen that, actually. Oh, we should do a salty bet night too. We need to do more special events. Yeah, that could be fun. I need more co-hosts for events? I mean, I guess. Do I really? You don't think I could carry it on my own? You don't think I could carry it on my own? The only co-host I have right now is Picture. And I already talked to that guy enough outside of the stream. I don't need to stream. I don't need to talk to him on stream, too. Damn. The flat, no? My night is going well, though. I'm having a great night. I hope your night is going well, as well. I mean, you're here now, watching the stream, so... Oh, I used up all my fucking grenades! Nice. Yeah, besides the utter lack of confidence in my hosting abilities, it's been going fantastic. Up until about 30 seconds ago, it was really great. Yeah, we need to do D&I soon, but I think D&I would be on your channel. The grenade launcher. I really don't like that they give you the grenade launcher here, because you just shoot the train with it. Like, they give you the grenade launcher in a situation where you use up all of your ammo on the train. It's very stupid. I never liked that about this game. I don't know why that's the first time you get the grenade launcher. It's so dumb. Well, I hope you had a nice day at work, Place. I hope you feel like you did a good job. I hope you were rewarded for your efforts. But yeah, I think D&I would have to be on your channel picture. I don't want to play Dwarf Fortress. I want to watch you play Dwarf Fortress and heckle the chat. Yeah, this really comes out of nowhere. I like Metal Slug X a lot, but I feel like it kind of, I don't know. It doesn't feel as cohesive, I guess, as some of the other ones. Can I get this, please? Thank you. Alright, I just want the laser. Just give me the laser, please. Thank you. Laser gun. Like, I feel like the levels kind of don't have as strong theming as they could. I feel like Metal Slug 3 does a much better job at theming the levels. Like, the zombie level in Metal Slug 3 is, like, a whole level, as opposed to just, like, half- I'm not even gonna fucking get this, I don't care. This is stupid. Yeah, heckling chat is my favorite thing to do. Heckling chat is my favorite thing to do, and it's my extra favorite thing to do during Dwarf Fortress streams. There's some real good heckling to be had during the drinking industry streams, let me tell you. There's a lot of people. A lot of people during the Dwarf Fortress streams that need to be heckled really hard. I did it again. That's like three vehicles in a row I've just self-destructed. Yeah, they make like a laser noise when they blow up. It's very weird. And they also blow up in like a regular explosion. It's not like a blood explosion. It's like a regular explosion. Yeah, the D&I streams is when I can let my real hater energy blow. When I can feel like a bully, and just feel justified. Thank you. Oh yeah, for those who don't know, I should probably... Drinking Industry is a series that I did with my friend Picture Point for a very long time, where he would teach me how to play Dwarf Fortress. And then once I learned how to play Dwarf Fortress, it was just... We would play Dwarf Fortress, and I would watch him play Dwarf Fortress. This thing is so fucking cool. All the laser effects on this thing are so sick. And the fact that you can, like, take it out piece by piece. It's so good. This is one of my favorite boss designs, for sure.
Oh!
Get out of here. No. Ah, that's so cool looking though. It looks so good. Damn, this thing has a lot of health. Holy shit. I've used so many grenades and it's still alive. Can you die? Can this be done? Oh, okay. Nice. Oh, they gotta dive into the shit water. Unfortunate. The toxic shit water. Mission complete. Oh, we're already at the final mission? That sucks. Alright, seven- okay, can I complete the final mission with seven or less game overs? I think I can do it. I think I can do it. Oh, really? That's not far enough? I think I can do it. Maybe I won't be able to host... Damn it. I might not be able to host... a solo... Salty Bet stream. But I can beat the last level of... Metal Slug X without dying 20 times. I think. Maybe I can't. Why? This is, like, insane. This is, like, so much harder than all the other levels. Alright, now it's time for everybody's favorite. I can't believe that they didn't record a separate voice line for him when he's facing not a boy. God damn it. To him, all soldiers are boys? Yeah, I guess. This is like the only part of the game where I just don't understand the pattern. This guy's boss fights is like the only time that I like legitimately don't understand what you're supposed to do. It's so sick! That's so unnecessary! They didn't have to do that. They made an entire Orca whale sprite just so that he could get eaten and turned into bones. It's so cool. They really didn't have to do that. Yeah, and it doesn't even kill him. Those were somebody else's bones. That was from the thing that the Orca ate right before him. Yeah, you actually never get the grenade launcher at any point in the game, besides that one train segment. That's so weird. Very bizarre. Fuck you, buddy. This shit ain't nothing to me, man. I've seen through the eye of the needle. Sorry. I'm feeling it now. Like, look at that. Look how gross and violent that is when they die. It's so good. This game is also definitely what sparked my love of intense blood and gore. Okay. Well, I wasn't gonna talk about those. We don't need to talk about those. I was too good at this game when I was a child, so I never saw any of them. I mean, I was thinking of them. I definitely was thinking about them, but I didn't say. I'm not the one that brought it up. You're the one that brought it up. I mean, this game definitely sparked a lot of things in my young imagination. Like, these aliens definitely have a lot of tentacles on them. They definitely have a lot of tentacles that move in a very hypnotic and provocative way. They do kind of come out of nowhere in this one. They feel kind of underutilized. As opposed to Metal Slug 3. Oh no, I don't know if I'm going to do it. I'm engaging with the chat too much. Oh yeah. Oh, they don't blow up when you hit them with the rocket launcher? Okay, there we go. They sometimes... Really? The hitbox on that is way too big. I actually have a keychain of these guys. I have a keychain of the aliens. God, I keep getting the cool weapons and then dying immediately. I'm so bad at this game. All of my skill has left me from, like, 20 years ago. Even more than that, actually. Oh my god. I don't want to think about that. No, the birthday thoughts are coming. Get them out of here. Get them out of my head. I don't want those.
No.
Oh, I'm losing it. I'm losing it. I'm losing focus really hard. Yeah, look at the legs fucking flying everywhere. Yeah, we've already been over this, Seamus. You know that there's been at least 15 hints that I'm over 20 years old. Actually, there's been at least, like, 100 hints that I'm over 20 years old if you count every single time that I've been drinking on stream. If you count every single time that I drink on stream, there's been plenty more than 54 hints that I'm over 20. Yeah, I guess that's true. I could be getting illegally drunk. I think I can do it. I've got three full credits to get a better score than... We're on the final boss. This shit's easy, man. This shit ain't nothing to me, man. I like how the aliens also have the Rebel Army logo on their spaceship for some reason. Okay, I thought you could move to the... I thought you could go a little bit more to the right there, but I guess not. I guess I could just also die. That's also an option. This thing has very cool looking attacks also. If it does any of them, it has very cool looking attacks. If it decides to do anything except spawn little guys, it does have cool looking attacks. Oh my god. I don't even know what those references would be. I want to try to avoid doing references. Okay, here we go. No! I know. I'm waiting on the alien reveal in One Piece. It's gotta happen eventually, right? Oh, really? That's kind of weird. I mean, I guess that depends on what the line was. It depends on how specific the line was, you know? There we go. It's from a Killer Mike song? Okay, that's fair then. This part's so cool, man. The mothership? Docking with the main platform? And then they pull out the black and yellow spaceships, the elites, the aces, the alien aces. Okay. Help me out, bros. We're on the same side now. Wow, these things have a lot of health. They really are aces. The black ships really are stronger. That paint job gives them an extra, like, way more health. Okay, here we go. Never mind. I think that's my curse. That's my curse this playthrough. Is to just die, eat shit as immediately. As soon as I get a gun, I just die. Yeah, they've got armament hockey. Oh no, I need to do it right now. I need to do it on this one. Otherwise, it's all over. It's all over, bros. Oh, they're giving me the tank, though. Okay. Get in the super vehicle. We got this shit. Oh, and we got the energy blast guy. We're good. We're good. It's all. No, I broke the tank. Fuck.
No.
Oh no, the fraud warning is in full effect. No, it's so over. It's so over. It's so over. No! God damn it! No! His sacrifice will never be forgotten. And then you get to see the zoom out. I don't think this is supposed to be the zoom out. I think it's just supposed to be maybe they left the other one behind or something. Or it like undocked and then blew up.
Mission complete.
Nice. Ooh, which Killer Mike song is that? I'm so upset. Alright, tomorrow, all other plans off. All other plans are off. We're only playing Metal Slug X until I can 1cc it. We're only playing Metal Slug X. I haven't listened to that one. I need to listen to that one. I haven't listened to Michael. I know, Killer Mike is like one of my favorite rappers. He's so good. I don't listen to that much rap, but the rap that I do listen to is very good. Enemy sequence is its own credit? What does that mean? Alright, I'm gonna get up for like 2 seconds. Enjoy the credits. I'll be right back. The character chief? What are these credits? They're just making shit up. They're just making up words. Who's in charge of getting the fresh vegetables to make sure everybody Oh, tool engineer is a normal title? What about hyper organizer? Is hyper organizer a common credit to give someone? I missed one, which was just wizard. Damn. Yeah, all of our credits All of our credits need to be fake, made-up titles. And it just needs to be... It just needs to be you and me. We're gonna be the only people credited, Carlos. And it just has to go back and forth. With just a bunch of made-up titles. Yeah, the Vibe Tutor. Look at that. Absolutely crushing the high score game. No. Picture doesn't care if people know his real name. He uses his real name on his own stream, so he doesn't care. Yeah, we should add a bunch of... Yeah, like online... Or like online division. Like GGPO implementer. Like just give credits to GGPO even though there's no online features or something. Yeah, rollback engineer. Just include a bunch of fake shit that like doesn't. It has nothing to do with the game. All right, we're gonna do. Yeah, just a bunch of community organizer. And there's no like Discord or anything. Look. I said this last night about being a drug dealer. I'm gonna say it again. I don't know if I'm gonna be a good game developer. I don't know if I'm gonna be a good game developer, but I'll definitely be a very funny game developer. We might not be very good game developers. We'll be very funny game developers. Yeah, we were talking last night, and I said I don't know if I would make a very good drug dealer, but I would make for a very funny drug dealer. I stand by that statement. Is that a real thing, Noel? I still can't tell when you're giving me real facts and when you're making things up. That could be real. That could be a real thing that happened. I wish I was your plug too, Shameless, because then that would mean that I would have drugs that I could do. Not as far as you're aware. All right, write it down. Write it down, picture. Put it in the books. Are you telling me that you would... Oh, that's what I was gonna say. Are you telling me you would steal his packages? But that's way funnier. That is both way funnier and the type of gay nerdy shit that you would do. That's, like, way more on-brand for you. I'm also upset that the studio name Acid Wizard is already taken. That was, like... That's, like... several seconds of loading. This port is fucked up. Yeah, that's the most... That's the most on-brand thing I think Picture's ever told in the stream. So, I have this correct, right? Metal Slug 3 is, like, widely considered the best one. I'm, like, not... I've always thought that was the thing. That's, like... I'm not just making that shit up, right? Like, the majority of people say that this is the best one. What is this? XX? I don't know if I've played XX. That might be one that I'm not familiar with. Is that the PSP one? What was the PSP one? I mean, you can find plenty of Metal Slug XXX out there. How did I get down there? There we go. I want to take this up. Yeah, this game has multiple paths in it. They didn't massacre your girl Theo, Seamus. That's the first time you see her in the entire series. They can't massacre her if that's her original look. The first time you ever see her is on the character select screen. So it can't be a massacre if that's just what she looks like. You know? Yeah, picture Metal Slug 3 is like insane. This is like the best game. This is like, look at this shit, man. This is a motherfucking video game right here. And this is like, this is an optional path. There's another path through this level. This is half of a level right here. What is the, okay, it's just a torpedo. Damn, this is, like, very awkward to control. to get into a good position for this. Ah. Nice. Hold on, we're pausing for a second. Alright, nobody in the chat said anything that I feel the need to respond to. That's good. Yeah, they were channeling their, they were channeling their in the hunt energy for this level. My about me is missing a space? Where? What do you mean? What did I fuck up? Is this the grammatical error that was alluded to so long ago? This route is way harder than the fucking above ground route. Holy shit, man. I always take the above ground route. This is crazy. I didn't know what it was! You told me that there was an error. I didn't fucking look at what it was. You expect me to just do things of my own volition? Why would I do that? Why would I do that? You expect me to be looking at things? Who do you think I am? I did it again. I hate that that's the thing. Oh no, that's like, is that fucked up? When I first published it, it didn't look like that. It's supposed to be like on a whole separate line. Are you not allowed to do that? It didn't look like that for me. Does it look different on like the actual chat page? When I edited it, it didn't look like that. I swear to God. It doesn't look like that in the, it just runs straight. Yeah, it's not supposed to look like that. That's not what it looks like on the settings page. That's not my fault. How are you supposed to format it then? I'm also not familiar with Theo's appearance in King of Fighters. Okay. I'm bad at this game, man. This boss is hard, and I'm drunk. This game's really hard. Why does it make you feel like this? Why does the game inject alcohol into your bloodstream every time that you die. That's kind of fucked up that they would do that. Oh, I'm getting way more than 17 in this one. I'm not good at this one. I'm really bad at Metal Slug 3. I was good at X for the first two stages. I cleared the first two stages without dying. That's fine. Okay. Oh, that was only the first mission? Oh, that's gonna be a long one. It's gonna be a long one, ladies and gentlemen. Ugh. I like the synthesized guitars in this level. There's literally everything in Metal Slug, Sheamus. There's every type of thing in Metal Slug. There's also this. There's also the coolest thing in any video game. Which is your grenade when you're a zombie. Oh, okay. I didn't have to do that. I mean, I always assumed that it was, like, magic. It was, like, alien magic that's turning everybody into zombies. Yeah. There's also this fucking thing. Does this thing show up ever again? Can you ever get the Thundercloud ever again? Okay, I didn't think so. What do you mean three? I didn't die yet. I'm a zombie. Hold your fucking horses over there, buddy. Let's calm down. Let's calm down over there, why don't we? Yeah, you can also tank hits as a zombie. The only thing that will kill you when you're a zombie is more zombie juice. Which I think is pretty cool. It's a nice little touch. But Now you can up the count. Now you can up the count. I want to keep the flame shot. Okay. I think I've missed a couple episodes of Undead Unlocked. God damn. I don't know. I guess they were distracted. I guess something more important than watching me be really bad at Metal Slug came up. I wasn't paying. I looked at the chat again. I looked at chat again and I died immediately. Yeah, it's very hard for me to keep up with currently running anime. I know when you're watching somebody like me play who dies this much. Okay, Oh, you can't crouch as a zombie. That's fucked up. Do not do that. Absolutely do not do that picture. You are barred. You're not allowed to do that. You don't actually want to do that. You're just copying me. Then just don't have your face on the stream. No, that was 5. You missed one. That was 5. If you go VTuber mode picture, I will never ever watch your stream ever again. I still have mod powers on your stream. I will watch your stream one time and I will ban every single person that enters the chat if you become a VTuber. I will ban every single person that enters the chat, and then when they're all gone, I'll ban myself. How about that? You do not want to do that. You absolutely do not have your heart in it. You're just saying things that you don't mean. You don't watch VTubers. You don't care about the craft. You have no vision. Just stop saying things that you don't mean. I told you last time, you don't have to be that guy. Just let me do my thing and you do your thing, and they don't have to be the same thing, okay? In fact, it's better that they're not the same thing. Look, I'm so mad at you right now, I'm in the zone. I don't remember what this boss's attack. Oh, this is the ball. Okay, this thing is sick. I forgot about this. I forgot that it drops fucking knowledge on you to kill you. The only time you'll ever see me angry, like legitimately angry in the chat, or legitimately angry on stream, is when Picture says something. You guys, the rest of you can say whatever you want and I'm not really gonna care. When Picture says something, I get triggered. It is true friendship. It is actually true friendship. That's also not a challenge. That's also not a challenge. Please do not take that as a challenge at all. If anybody else said that, I wouldn't care. But coming from you, I start to sweat. If anybody else said that, I wouldn't mind. But you saying that, I get like... I feel like there's a presence behind me. I sense a presence lurking behind me. You can just stream without having a camera picture. It's fine. You don't have to, like... If you don't think that that's what you want to do. But why do you feel that that's the case? What don't you like about having your face on screen? Because I think you do a good job of, like, emoting and, like, reacting to stuff. In my opinion. I'm getting, like, way too... distracted right now. There's like way too much shit going on the screen and in the chat and outside of the screen and in my brain. I mean, I said this before, Picture. I don't know if you were there. I've told you this before too. You just need to put on the stream that you want, that you would watch. Think about the type of stream that you want to watch and then just do that. You know? Yeah, but why don't you watch streams? what about them don't you like? If you did watch them, why would you? You know, you're clearly attracted to it in some way. If you yourself want to stream, you know. I also want to play Sub Rebellion. Oh, I went inside? I didn't know you could do that. Is this like an alternate? What happened? I don't know what's going on. I know, Picture, you could never make a... Also, Seamus is right. You could never make a VTuber model that's more attractive than you are in real life. You don't need to hide behind a VTuber model. You've already got the charm. You don't need to pretend. Hey buddy, can you come down here? No? Okay. This is just recycled from Metal Slug X. Yeah, I don't remember this part. I don't know if I knew that you could do that. What? Oh my goodness! I blacked out again for a second there, I'm sorry. There he is! Oh yeah, I don't remember- I definitely did not do this route very many times playing this game. I don't remember this part. Look at how smooth that animation is. Oh, it's one of these. Okay, can we like... Can we calm down? I didn't mean- can the guy go to the easier route now? I don't like this. Okay. I saved Randall Thimes. Have you been keeping up? Oh god! Hold on, I need to concentrate for a minute. Yeah, I was gonna say, the game also is definitely very horny. But in like a violent way. Okay, I don't remember this boss at all. The people who made this game definitely had a very specific set of fetishes. Oh my god. I'm pretty sure you're watching a death compilation, by the way. I don't think you need to look up a death compilation. I'm pretty sure you're watching one right now. I think you're going to see every possible way to die in this game by the time we're done here. Okay. Damn. I don't know what I want to... Okay, I'll save this for the end of the stream. You can kill the camel! You can suicide the camel! Why is that an option? No, don't look up the fucking deaths. Just watch the stream. Stop directing people away from the stream. Don't do that. Only I'm allowed to do that. Yeah, we're going way over. We're going way over 17. I'm sorry. Oh, is this the one we... Oh, how do you go to the training grounds? I want to go to the training grounds. I know you leave footprints in the sand. It's the greatest game ever. This is the greatest game ever made, so... Of course you leave footprints in the sand. That would actually be incredibly easy to do in a 2D game, by the way. It is a very cool detail, but it's also, like, incredibly easy to do. Yeah, sorry, I'm giving away 25-year-old secrets of game dev technology. I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, I don't want to go to the temple, I want to go to the training grounds. Yeah, you have to go down here. I'm pretty sure this is the training grounds. Like, look at that incredibly detailed screen that you only see once. God, this game is so good, man. Is that in a different game? Where's the, Did I go to the wrong route? Ugh. Maybe I did need to go up. Okay. God damn. I'm just getting annihilated. Like, look at how detailed that animation is for these fucking guys. That's his entrance. I know what that means. No, yeah, you go to the secret, another screen that nothing happens on. That's incredibly detailed. You go to the secret, World War II Japanese encampment in the desert where they're training. This is like one of my favorite areas in all of the Metal Slug games because it's just so... And they have like the fake tanks. It's just so off the wall. It makes no sense. It's so good though. God. I can get ammo for the gun that I don't have. Oh my God. I mean, it's like semi-fake. It's a semi-fake tank. I love this part too, where they have the planes on the track. It's so good. Ugh. These are not good games to play when you're drinking. They do not lend themselves very well to, casual play. I think that that's literally the idea, Noel. I think that that is, like, what this is supposed to be. Is that they, like, hunkered down here to, like, train and prepare themselves for the war, and they just literally never got... they never got the memo that it was over. Okay. I don't remember this thing's pattern. This is a very memorization-heavy game. Oh, I got turned into gold. That's kind of cool, actually. I mean, a lot of arcade games are, but this one... the Metal Slug games especially... you don't have very good movement options, so you really just need to know what's coming before it happens. Otherwise, you don't have a chance. Can you stop doing this? Thank you. Oh! It's so many wolf spirits! It's so many ancient Aztec wolf spirits to kill me. To fucking annihilate my ass. My western ass. My white girl booty. Destroyed by ancient Aztec wolf spirits. There it is. Alright. No, I called it. I knew that this was gonna happen. Way early on. Alright. Wow! That's just not fair. This is on normal mode, too? This isn't even the hard mode? Oh my god. I need to start doing the shoot-em-up thing. I need to start doing the shmup thing where I only look at my character. I don't look at the rest of the screen at all. You just focus on your character. How many missions are in this game, by the way? Is this the last one, or do we have more? That was tough. That was a difficult boss. I'm not good at this game. Ooh, we haven't done the helicopter yet. Okay, this is the final one. Okay. That's what I thought. Yeah, it's like hard to tell when you're just watching, but the movement in this game is kind of stiff. Like, not in a bad, like, it's deliberate, obviously, but it's not, you don't have as much, it's harder to be reactive, I guess, in this game. You really have to, oh, that's what our bomb is. Okay. You have to, like, anticipate things. Go! Okay. Oh. These clouds are also very detailed. I told you, this is the cinematic game series. These games are like way more cinematic than you would expect. And you can run along the ground. You'd be a cool guy and run along the ground. No, get in! Oh, you fucker. You motherfucker. That is a good point, though. When we make our Metal Slug ripoff, we'll be sure to include that as a feature. Yeah, exactly. Noted. Write it down, picture. Put it in the book. When we make our slug like. It will have that. I actually can't talk. I actually physically am unable to talk at this venture, at this juncture in my life. There we go. Well, right now, there's only one character, but it's a very complicated character. There's, like, way more mechanics in the Slug-like than, actual Metal Slug. There's only one playable character. The sequel will have two. The sequel will have two characters. I haven't floated the idea to picture yet, but the sequel will have two characters that you can play as. That's the plan already. Oh no, he's back! Yeah, we can include DLC characters. We have a lot of options here. Damn, this thing has a lot of health too. What the hell? It also just keeps doing the same attack pattern. Please die. Please just die. Okay. This thing has way too much health. Who decided that this was gonna be it? Who decided that this was how much health this fucking plane should have? Jesus. The plane health inspector? Oh, okay. Is that gonna be somebody in the credits? Plane health decider? Heavy machine gun. Oh, thanks for the sub picture. I appreciate that. Didn't you already do that? Didn't you, like... I feel like you just subscribed, like, the other day. But, is it past midnight, by the way? Did it just hit past midnight? Is it actually my birthday now? Well, oh, okay. Thanks. Thank you. I appreciate that. Ah! I was doing so good, too. Ah! Make it stop, make it stop, make it stop. Go away, go away. Oh. Come on. Oh no. That was bad. That was quick. That was a quick credit. I don't think the gun turret is working out for me. The gun turret is not my friend in this situation, I don't think. There we go. There we go. I was waiting for it. Oh yeah, that fucking synth guitar. We gotta go save her! We have to go save my waifu! We have to go save my beautiful virtual wife, Aerie. I guess she really was my first waifu, if I think about it. She really is the OG. I wasn't thinking on those terms, because I was too young for that. Look at this fucking sick-ass launch sequence. This game is so good, man. But yeah, I wasn't thinking on those terms back then. I was too young. But I guess she really is. She really is the OG. I must give respect where it's due. If anybody ever asks me from now on who my waifu is, it has to be... It's gotta be Aerie. I don't think I can, in good conscience, give a different answer. Oh, you don't have a grenade. Oh wait, you do. Okay, they just kinda like... Oh, I see how they work. That's pretty cool, actually. I definitely played Metal Slug before I played Disgaea. I had to think about that for a minute. Metal Slug definitely came first. Give me a laser. I definitely played Metal Slug X before Disgaea. I don't know. I never really yeah. Although, like I said, I played Metal Slug X the most, and that's not... It doesn't... The deaths in that one aren't as violent as they are in, the other games. They're not as bad. Give me the shotgun. Damn, there's a distinct lack of shotgun in this game, I just realized. Maybe that's why X is my favorite. You need to stop watching the stream picture. You're picking up on too many bad... I'm such a bad influence on you, I've realized. I, like, always knew that I'm, like, a really bad influence on you, but it really hasn't hit home until, like, just recently. It's because it's still happening. You used to be such an innocent person before you met me. You used to be so pure, I feel like. And then I came along and I fucked it all up. You really don't deserve a friend like me. But in like a bad way. Like not as in you don't deserve me because I'm too good for you. You don't deserve me because like I'm a status ailment inflicted upon you. I'm like a debuff to your general outlook on life. How did I know about- Cause I'm a fucking... What do you mean? I can't answer a question like that. How do you expect me to be able to answer a question like that? Don't say that. I don't want anybody to know my real age. Please don't even make jokes about it. You didn't even know Jacob was real. I know, by the time that I met you, Picture, like, the word weeb had already started to lose its meaning by the time that I met you. The word weeb had already started to lose its meaning. I know, you never would have known if not for me. Again, just another negative impact that I've had on your life. Yeah, you would have known about Urban Filthy Frank. I'm sorry if the conversation is getting a little esoteric at this point. Oh, give me that ammo. Please, I need those rocket launchers. I'm sorry if the conversation is getting kind of personal, but... Picture and I have a... Carlos and I have a very long history, and sometimes it comes out on the streams. We have a very long checkered past together. That sometimes I can't help but indulge in on the streams. I don't want anybody to feel like they're not the... I don't want anyone to feel like they're not being included. No! You can't go through it! Okay, it's got collision on it. You feel incredibly included? That's good. I hope you're not being sarcastic. God, it just keeps going! They were fucking on one when they made this game. Why would you be? I don't know. I don't know anything anymore. I'm so overstimulated at this point. I don't know what's happening. This background is too much. They need to tone this down. I am stimmed up and gooned out. Both of those things. I do not remember the ending of this game being this intense, by the way. I knew that the whole alien thing happened. I don't remember it being this fucking crazy. We're not even, like, at the halfway point, I don't think. There's, like, a whole on-foot section after this. I didn't want that. Laser gun. Enemy chaser. Ah. I kind of wanted to keep the enemy chaser. Oh, never mind. Rocket launch is probably better for this part. Okay. Ah! Oh! Okay. No, I knew there was gonna be another one. Yeah, the rocket launcher does have a little bit of homing. It has enough in this section. No! Stop, stop, stop. Ugh. I was not ready for that one. This is not gonna end, is it? This section is just gonna go on forever. This section is just gonna never stop. Holy shit. Oh, he's fucking... I forget what the name for that is when you go behind the... Okay, I actually have to get up for a second. Drafting, that's what it's called. I actually have to get up for a second. I don't want to kill the momentum, but I need to get up. The stage is way too fucking long. Alright. I'll be right back. Drafting. I don't know racing. I don't know racing. I only know burnout. Alright, I'll be right back. This is a short one. Man, this shit is so sick, dude. This shit's so fucking sick. I'm so gassed up right now. I'm really feeling it. I'm feeling the juice. I'm feeling juicy. This shit's so sick. You know, I've been thinking about it. I've been thinking about this. I don't really care. I don't, like, have a preference for, like, what pronouns people use for me on the stream. But, I do think of, the character as female. So I was thinking about adopting female pronouns on the stream. It wouldn't be like a strictly enforced rule. It would be more like a soft rule, you know, where it's like that's the preference, but it's not enforced. I don't know if I could do that in good conscience. I don't know if I could really pull that off. I think I say things like, this is so fucking sick, dude. I don't know if that really... I don't know if I would feel comfortable. I don't know if I would feel comfortable being called a lady when I use sentences like that. That's not very ladylike talk, I feel. I don't know. I say dude too much for that to be, like, a thing. Yeah, I would feel like I'm appropriating trans culture if I did that. I don't know, it just doesn't feel right to me. It just doesn't feel correct. I don't know. But maybe I'm just sexist. I know, maybe I'm just sexist towards myself, I guess. I know. Are you saying pretty asleep of me as in, like, the opposite of woke? Is that what you're trying to do? I don't know if I like that either. I don't know if I could, in good conscience, let you say that either. I think it would have been cool if when you have to go save your character, like your character gets kidnapped and you have to save yourself. I think it would be cool if the character select screen came up again. That would have been a nice touch. Yeah, I don't know. I don't actually want to enforce any rules like that on the stream. I dodged that so perfectly without even thinking. I'm in the zone right now. I think maybe my frame of reference on like womanhood and femininity is probably very skewed because I don't actually talk to any women. I've never actually spoken to a woman before, so I can't like make an accurate judgment on like how they talk. I don't know, that's not confirmed. That's still unconfirmed. I'm not really afraid of the social judge. I'm very heavily socially judged on this stream all the time anyway, that I don't think it really matters at this point. I'm just a vehicle for your enjoyment. I can't impose upon you any kind of like criteria for how you should view me. Not getting the drop shot. I really didn't mean to. I shouldn't have phrased things in that way, but I got fucked over there. Because I ran out of ammo, and they have a little animation for when you switch back to your pistol. Oh, the goop! Avoid it! Avoid the goop! I really wish these things showed up again. They're like so incongruous with the rest of the alien designs. They like don't fit. It's very odd. Oh shit, this guy's elite. This guy leveled up. Actually, all the alien, there's like not really a unified like... There's not really a unified alien designs. What the fuck is that? I don't remember this thing. It's making the game slow down, that's for sure. Yeah, the Martians are the tentacle guys. These are Venusians, yeah. But it's just weird that they're like working together and they're in the same spaceship. Like, it doesn't really make sense. I don't know. Maybe I'm asking too much of the Metal Slug lore. Oh, that kills you. Okay, that's sick. That's fucking epic, dude. Yeah, the Intergalactic Council. They're unified. Yeah, it's definitely not an art oversight. Nothing in this game was an art oversight, I'll give you that. Yeah, I don't know, I don't think the last level of Metal Slug 3 is maybe the greatest opportunity to be talking about gender identity and things like that. I think maybe there's probably a better time to be talking about those topics than right now, while this is happening on screen. I think maybe we should save that for a different day. God, this thing is so cool. The acid deaths are incredible because, like, they give you a fetish. You might not think that you're attracted to a woman being melted by acid to death, and then you see that and you're like, ah, I don't know. When you put it like that, I think I can understand where you're coming from. You don't think you're into that, and then you play Metal Slug, and all of a sudden... A whole new world of possibilities opens up before you. This stage just keeps going, dude. Oh yeah, no, this is the payoff. You lose your favorite character by picking them for this section of the game, but this is the payoff. This is where that part of the game, this is where that gets paid off. I forgot about this. Oh! Armor piercers! The best power-up in the game. Yeah, examine, now that I'm playing this again after having not played it for a very long time, there's so many things about my life that make sense now. There's just so many things about my life that make sense now. I will say, though, I think that the game is starting to wear out its welcome. I think maybe they went a little too hard on the final stage. Oh my god, no! Oh, he's helping us. I forgot they're our friends now. What did I just pick up that gave me 0 points? Oh, the alien eggs give you 0 points. That's so weird. Do they hatch? No. What a weird little detail. I don't know. We don't know what they are, we don't know where they come from, we don't know what they mean. It's probably best not to be asking these types of questions. It's probably way better to not be thinking about this kind of stuff. Hold on, where's that ricochet coming from? I guess it just bounces off random parts of the inventory. I can't really tell what's causing that. No, it's too late. It's already too late. It's been settled. We got her back. We saved my girl. And she's ready to kill. She requires nothing, and then they just let you watch it. Wow, we're still going, huh? This is fucking crazy, man. Oh, and they even animated like the little locks like opening on these doors. That's so crazy. That's so good. This game is so good. I know, they were really feeling themselves when they made this game. They kind of went sicko mode when they made this. This is like, this final level is like as long as the rest of the game, which is kind of fucked up. Flame shot. I deserve that. I was just standing still. Yeah, I remember this level being really long. I don't remember being this fucking crazy. I do not remember being this much. When did I get a flame shot? I don't even remember. No! Oh. I'm actually so upset. I don't get to use the robot. And I'll take the drop. I deserve the drop shot. I'll take the L on that one. I deserve the drop shot. Whatever, man. Whatever, bro. I don't care. And I picked Fio by accident. It's so over. It's so over, bros. Oh, I tried to duck it. I was too slow. Go, go, go. Please go. Okay. Oh, I couldn't pick her yet. Okay. Nice. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. It's so crazy to me in sprite-based games that it's like... anytime you want to do something, you have to animate it by hand. Like, they had an animation there of the SV01. Like... okay, that's not a good time for a loading screen. Like, flipping around in the air, they had to hand animate that. Because you just couldn't do it any other way. You know? Like, that was just, like, what they had to do. There was no other option. What is the, what's the strat here? Oh, you can just jump over it. Okay. Give me that food. Give me that canned food. Okay, I thought I mistimed it. This thing is so cool. You can ride this thing as a vehicle in the next game. There's like a secret route where you can use this thing as a vehicle. Okay. Okay. Super grenade. Yeah, G is the grenade launcher, which is it shows up incredibly rarely. It's a very underutilized weapon in the entire series. No! Help me out, Aerie, please! You're gonna have to do more than that. Your dinky little alien UFO is not gonna be enough. Thank you, Picture! Thank you for the hot tip. I appreciate that. I looked at the chat to see the message of how many times I've died, and I died again. You'd think I would have learned my lesson by now, but unfortunately... alright. I think we're good here. I think it's about time to end the stream after this. I know, we're going bankrupt. Our entire tuition, all tuition money gone. At this point. It's over. We're in debt at this point. We're so far in debt. We're so far in debt. Oh. Is it actually over? Mission complete. Oh. Mission all over. Oh, that's it? That's kind of disappointing. Also, I just realized, Noel, it tells you how many continues you have at the end. You totally didn't have to be doing that, but... I guess that's fine. I guess that's fine. Aw, look at Aerie's bashful little pose right there. Alright, let's see what we got in the credits this time. Look at that! Look at how good that looks! And the bubbles forming? I'm telling you, man, this is a fucking cinematic series. Is that a Webley Mark IV? That's a good-looking gun. That is a very aesthetically pleasing firearm, if I do say so myself. I might have to get me one of those at some point.
A Smith & Wesson.
Curry. This is the type of this is how I want to be credited. I just want to be credited as Massive. I never want to use my, like... I never want to use my government ID. I never want to use my government name on any fucking... document that I don't have to. If Uncle Sam's not involved, I don't want to use my real name. Also, look at the audacity of these guys. Look at the audacity of these people to put underscores on their names. The future is now. It is a sick game picture. One of the best ever. Possibly the best ever. Man. So happy. Alright. I'm very glad we got to do a Metal Slug night. And we may do another one tomorrow. I don't know. We'll see. We played all the ones I care about. I'll just say that much. We played all the Metal Slug games that I care about. All the other ones are still good, but they're not, like... They're not formative, you know? They're not, like... No, Symphony of the Night stream is, like... That's, like, a break glass scenario. The Symphony of the Night stream is, like, a... That's, like, an end of world scenario. We need to work up to that. Yeah, that is the 1K follower special. I've never played the Saturn version. I've never played the Saturn. I didn't know that the Saturn version was like better until very recently. That was like a late in life discovery that there's like a Saturn version and it's like better than any other version. Yeah, it has added content because it came out later. It's actually got like extra shit in it. Yeah, I know. I didn't know that either. I didn't know that was a thing. I haven't played that one, so I don't know. I don't know. Where's the beer from? It's from Georgia. It's from Athens, Georgia. Creature Comforts Brewing Company in Athens, Georgia. They got good stuff. I like their stuff. I've had a few of their beers, and they're good. But yeah, he's nice. He's not. You familiar with? I should have known you're familiar with them. But yeah, I don't think I have too much to say. I just feel really good. I'm like really happy. I know that that's like maybe like not the most interesting thing for me to talk about, but like I'm just vibing. I'm just vibing out. I feel so good right now. I'm just so happy. So I hope y'all are happy too. I really do. I cannot stress that enough. I really can't. I just like. I don't know. I'm gonna put the music on. It's time to put the music on. Give me a second here. Yeah, I really appreciate everybody coming out to watch the stream. I really appreciate everything, I guess. I just appreciate life in general. I don't know. We live in mystifying times. We live in strange and mystifying times, and I feel blessed. I feel truly blessed to be living through these times with all of you as well. So, I hope that you feel the same. Yeah, cleanse thyself. Please cleanse thyself. You're gonna need it. I don't know. I'm having a good time. I'm having a good time streaming. I'm having a good time doing shit. I'm having a good time, like, existing in reality, which usually is not the case. Usually, existing as a physical entity in space is like an arduous experience that I'm not a fan of. But lately, it's not so bad. And Metal Slug definitely makes the medicine go down a little smoother. So, I appreciate that. I appreciate that Metal Slug exists, I guess. I kind of muddled up two thoughts there, but. I don't know. I say this shit every stream. You know what the deal is. You know what the deal is. I don't have to reiterate. Not yet. Nah, not yet. Not yet. But, fraud will never be. I will always be a fraud. I will always be a fraud. But, yeah, once the brick and mortar studio is established, then maybe the Doomer period will be fully behind us. But, yeah, I don't know. I feel too warm and fuzzy right now. I feel too warm and fuzzy to be continuing the stream. There's no point. There's no point, really. I'm not worried about this. This is the least worried I've ever been, Zagams. Thank you. This is the least worried I've ever been. I'll probably be back tomorrow. I got a couple different things I could do. I got a couple different ideas for what I could do tomorrow. I kind of want to make the like actual birthday Gitaru Man stream a thing. Because I did that last year and it was really fun, so I kind of want to do it again. We could play Master Mode this time. We could play Master Mode and watch me just, like, fucking lose my mind. I'm not saying... I won't even... If I play Master Mode, I'm not even going to get to the last boss. We are not even going to get that far if I play on Master Mode. We're going to get to, like, fucking... We're going to get to the second level, and then I'm going to have to quit. But... Yeah, I have a few things that I could do. I don't know. I'll probably be back tomorrow. I thank you all for hanging out. Thanks for being here. Thanks for being cool. Thanks for being, like... Yeah, thanks for being cool. Thanks for hanging out. I don't know. I think... Yeah, Churl is streaming. We'll raid Churl. I feel like spreading the love. It's time to, time to spread the love a little bit. I like Churl. He's a cool guy. I don't really watch that many streams. I don't really know that many streamers that I would feel comfortable raiding. And he's, like, the only one. He's, like, one of the only ones, and he's streaming right now, so might as well. I don't know if I'll watch the stream too much, but... Yeah, we'll go and say what's up. Yeah. I really appreciate everybody, so thank you for hanging out. Thanks for being here. It was another really fun stream. And, I guess that's that. I will see you all next time. I will see you all... Probably tomorrow, I guess. But, yeah. Thanks for being here. Thanks for hanging out. And I will see you next time. Peace.